Hey everybody, what's going on? This is Jordan, and I'm bringing you a race here with the car you're looking at, which is the, I don't even know what it is. I believe it's the Ferrari 312. It's from the 70s Grand Prix section, so it's a, it's like a 1976 Ferrari 312, I think, something like that. The paint job I have on it is custom. It's a carbon fiber polished finish. I just felt like doing that the last time or two, like the last video I had uploaded with the Ferrari F458 Italia. I had the stock paint on there, which had, you know, tons of like sponsors and vinyls and stuff, which is what the actual car looks like, because these are all based off of real cars. And so this one was, I don't know, I just felt like painting a different color. So this is a race on the track Sebring. This is my track that I upload most of my cars with. You'll see right here that I'm going to rewind this about 5 different times at least, and I can't get past this guy without going off onto the side. That's one of my pet peeves with this is, you know, sometimes you get kind of stuck in a situation like this, and look at that, there it is again. This is definitely not the best race. I definitely could have found some better ones to upload. But on this track particularly, and this is sort of my control track, so I test kind of my feel for the cars based on this track and Prague, which I also have another video coming after this one on Prague, with this same car, excuse me. But I just, I like to get the view at the beginning of a couple camera shots to kind of get a look at what the car looks like, and then, you know, like I said, just a sort of a control lapse on this one. So I did start out with the regular view, and then I do switch to the driver view sometime in the second lap, I believe. Unfortunately, with this one, now that I'm at the, higher tier of cars, I'm not really able to get full races on this one. Some of my videos I have on this track are actually full races. This one, I'm not going to be able to do. In fact, I think this one I only go to, midway or at the end of the second lap, I think. This car right here, I mean, if this is preview of cars to come, I'm very excited. One of the things that they've done a really good job with this game is the whole feel and the physics of it. When you're driving a car really fast, it feels like you're going really fast. When you're turning, it feels like you're turning. When you're braking, it feels like you're, slowing down, and just, some of the cars, they just... And with the vibration triggers on this Xbox One, that's one of the other things I wanted to talk about. It really feels like you're really pushing, really pushing the limits of the car. I mean, it does a really good job of sort of, pulling you into the game and making it feel like you're actually there driving the car, Tires screech and they ratchet, and, I find myself white-knuckling it on the controller all the time on this game. I'm just coming in and turn, I'm just like, oh, come on, hold on. Just really just... begging the car to just hold on for dear life, just pushing it as hard as I can and trying to get the most out of the car through every single corner. And that's part of the reason why I've been uploading so much on this. I'm typically a Call of Duty player, and I've been really into Call of Duty the last couple years, 5 years, and I know it's more than a couple, but here's a driver view here. And with this game's just got me so hooked. It's just it's just riveting. It does get repetitive, don't get me wrong. There's only, I've said it a couple times, but there's only about 12 or 13 tracks. Getting to use different cars is a plus, but it's really just sort of a, it does get a little repetitive. But I mean, it just, at least for the while that I'm playing it through, one series or a series and a half, it's just really, really riveting, white knuckling it, really just getting into it and really feeling like you're driving the car. And that's one of the best things about it. Obviously it's a driving simulator, but I mean, it's truly, it does everything it can to drag you in, especially with the Turtle Beach and stuff like that. It turned really loud, it really makes you feel really, in there. So make sure you guys check out the next video with this car that's going to be on Prague, and I won't be doing commentary the whole time. I'll let you guys sort of hear the car. I'll do commentary there for a little bit at the beginning and then throw it to the car. But I appreciate you guys watching. Make sure if you liked the video that you subscribe. I do upload a couple times a week, and I do have plenty of other videos on my channel. So I appreciate you guys watching. Thank you.